Automata as a production was incredibly challenging. It was a period piece, which is super expensive, that had robots, which is also really expensive. Luckily, this project had a lot of people who were passionate about what Automata is and about the world and the story and about what we wanted to accomplish with it. This is day seven, right, Tony?
Yeah.
We are at the Georgetown steam plant, and we are shooting the big Luddite rally scene, which will be very challenging, but also extremely fun.
That was a trip, because it is an old steam plant. It's this giant old cement building that used to make steam, I guess.
You just showed up there, and it was just already the location that you would see on film.
Well, for this wide, I think we just need to get the establishing wide, and then get the close-up of the speech.
Who among you will join me? Who among you will be the hand of God?
That said, it's an old steam plant. It's cold. It's wet. It's dripping. There's parts you just don't go into.
It's like 40 degrees in here.
It's a refrigerator. It's a concrete fridge.
We had to get really creative with the ways in which we shot that scene because of the limitations that we had, where we were shooting out on catwalks.
In the scene, do you just want to just go throughout?
I'll just do one axis. You know, I'll lock down the camera.
Yeah, I like that.
Once we put all the actors into place and we yelled action, the energy in there was incredible. Really, really is one of the stronger parts of the series.
There we go. Settle, and action.
That's how you do it, brothers!
I think every set has its challenges, but doing a shoot where there is visual effects, your workflow is a little bit different, where we're working with actors that are wearing motion capture masks.
There's a hood and then like a kind of a band around my forehead with dots on it and then actual like marks on my face.
Going from the bands on the heads to the robot heads being, oh my God, they're so great.
He wasn't wearing the robot mask when we were filming, so I could actually look in his face and we could, you know, be two actors playing a scene, which was incredibly valuable.
Working with the CGI stuff, which is just using your imagination, because the thing that you're looking at, the person that you're looking at, can oftentimes not be there. You're looking at a silver ball instead.
Hold on, silver ball.
I don't know if that's clean enough for you.
Hey, buddy.
Oh, hi. Nice silver ball you got there.
Thank you. Silver ball.
One of the biggest compliments that we've seen is when we show people that they don't even know that it's CG, that they think it's practical. I'm very thankful to have such an amazing visual effects team working on the project.
This is day 11 of 12. This is our second to last day. We're here at the Merchant Cafe's hotel.
Yeah, place. Saloon.
Saloon, B&B. And we're shooting the scene today where Sam meets his ex-partner. I get to meet Tommy's new partner.
Pardon me.
Nope, then I get hit by a door.
You guys should have knocked.
No, you're fine.
Whatever. Zach?
Don't worry about it.
That's what we're shooting today. It's cool, Zach. What? Just walked into the scene.
Yeah, you just walked right in and cut.
yeah, perfect framing. This is great.
With an anal Sammy Regal.
Hello, Tommy.
You gotta call my suit guy, Sam. I'll give you his number.
Being that Automata is set in sort of the 1920s, 1930s, a lot of our locations had to have that same sort of feel from that era.
Seattle is not 1920s New York City, so we don't have as many historic buildings and districts, and I thought we did a really good job of choosing locations and choosing frames really well.
The camera's coming here, looking at an over on St.
We're here eating lunch after 5. I think if I see any of this.
So much of the interior and exterior locations are in older buildings, but if you looked just a second more to the right, there's a dumpster that we couldn't move.
We are shooting the opening scene of Automata. So hopefully it works. We only have four beer bottles, so we only have four takes.
One, take one.
Looking at it, throwing the ball. And cut there.
Hold on. Don't throw it, don't throw it.
I have a resetting, guys, resetting. One, take three. Alrighty, electrical department. We had a light blow. That was awesome.
Wow.
There's your take.
A little.
Art department. Everybody better come around. Once you hit that green pole, you can get outwards. Awesome, great. Hey, we got a light up! And let's roll it! Alrighty, guys, that's a wrap for the night. Thank you very much. Let's pack it up.
Thank you, everybody.
Feel good? Got one more day left, which is going to be in an alley, and it's going to be raining, pouring, so it's going to be a fun day. Right, Kristen? Tomorrow? Fun day?
So good.
That's my crew.
The last day was it was pouring down rain. We were shooting overnight and there was a fight scene. There's the fight scene in the alley in the rain, which is like, we got rain, hooray. But if it works, it works. And you know, and I trust Van enough to know that if he needs it, then he needs it. He's not just being indulgent.
I felt that we all suffered together in solidarity for art, which feels right.
Why did the 1930s gangster become an optometrist? Because he wanted to help people, see?
Working with this cast and crew was an absolute dream. And so walking onto set was like walking back into a club that you've been a member of.
My favorite memories are the camaraderie of it. It was comfortable and good and easy.
We were really lucky to have the amazing crew that we did and to have the size of crew that we did. And I think at the end of the day, everyone had a really great experience and are really proud of the project they made.
I couldn't have done this without an incredible team and key departments and positions, and very grateful that we got the opportunity to make this. We can't wait to show people more of the world of Automata.
Yeah, that's a wrap. That's a wrap. Super fast. Good job, guys. Good job, guys. Thank you guys so much.
Thanks, everybody. You're awesome.
Just doing BTS. Nobody watches BTS. Just a bunch of dickheads and weirdos.